Exercise 9, show compressor status. So the goal is to show the image of a compressor and show or hide it according to the variable representing the status of the compressor. Comp 1, comp 2, 3 and 4. If you have seen the previous exercise, you know how to do it. Find a good image for the compressor, place it in the page, right click, add simple dynamic, and according to the variable comp 1, you can change the visibility. But in this case, we will do something different. We will create our first widget. In this system, they are called object display. So other object display like this, like the rotating fan, it has three parameters, variable, speed, and don't remember, and the color, if I'm not wrong. The circular gauge has 100 parameters. This one will have just one, the one that defines the visibility. So where you can indicate the variable that make the compressor image visible or not. So let's start it. First of all, we have to find a good image for the compressor. If you remember in the introduction, I told you that in the Karel library, in the object display, there is the category 4 symbols with images of the Karel products or the device of our market. One of these is for the compressors. Here we don't see the image. I told you that the preview is here in the library. So reopen the same category. So symbols, probes, terminals, compressors, this one. So this picture, I think it uses a scroll compressor. So I will search for this one. Generic scroll off and on. Well, this is gray. This is green, I prefer to use the green one. So the generic scroll on. It is the last, so it should be generic this one. Yeah, in fact, generic scroll on. Open, okay, here is. Okay, very important, don't edit this, don't change this. That is, don't change the content, not only the widget, but in general, the content of the Karel library and also the Advise library. Why? Because if it is allowed theoretically, but don't do that, because in event later on you update the library, you will lose your modification. Okay, I will repeat this thing in I think is the very last exercise. So don't change this, but let's create a copy. So right click, copy, and paste in the project library. So in the object display, open. Also here you have one predefined folder layout, more or less like here. So if you want, you can create new folders just to create your own organization of your widgets. If you are not interested, you can delete. So paste somewhere in this node of the display, right click, paste. I will rename my generic scroll on just to easily distinguish the original one with my custom one. Double click. And here is. So this is the original, this is my generic scroll on. Well, just to avoid to modify it for mistake, I close it. So my generic scroll on. So we can start creating the attributes, the parameters. You can do it from here, file, parameters. I hope it's not confusing. The menu is parameter, they will appear in the attributes list, but okay, is it attribute or parameter? Basically is the same thing. parameter, the name is visible, I think is a good name, description visibility. So this is the name that will appear in the attributes here. Behavior we will see later in the next exercise, exact meaning, so just set to mandatory and leave here address. Is visible visibility. Finish. Next step, we have to show and hide, make visible or not visible this shape according to that attribute. You already know how to do this, so click, right click, add a simple dynamic. So in the previous exercise we used we click this button, the browse button, in order to select a variable of the project. This time we have to click this to activate the relative addressing that let you to select one of the parameters of this widget. There is a predefined name that is based, but I don't use it. I use the new one. Remember to change the data type, Boolean. Here below is, like before, the visibility. So true, visible, false, invisible. Okay, finish. Now we have to save, important because if you use it without save, you will see and you will use the old version, let's say. So to use what we have done so far, we have to save. I will repeat this also later in another exercise. So save, now we can use it. Drag and drop. Change the size. So for this compressor, the visibility is defined, you see, is visible is the name of the parameter, but the description is visibility. So in this case it is driven by the digital variable comp1. This is the status of the compressor. Now copy and paste for the second. Paste. So this is compressor 2, okay, 3 and 4. 3. And 4. Now we can try to place them equally distributed. We can use the align and arrange available also here in the toolbar. We can start distributing horizontally and then distributing vertically. Okay, looks good. We can take the opportunity to show here below also a switch showing the enable of the compressor, because of the application that we have in the CPICO has also these parameters. We can use a simple switch. We can place it horizontally. So this is the right moment to show this. So when you click, you see appear square handles that lets you to change the size. If you click and click again, the handles became a circle. Because this lets you to rotate according to the center of rotation, see, like this. So the center of rotation is very important if you need to rotate the widget. The other handles, these are used to skew in this way. Okay, undo. Now I can rotate this way, This is for the compressor too big, a little smaller. Okay. Compressor 1, so the variable is enable compressor 1. Copy, paste, no. Copy, Ctrl C, Ctrl V, V, V. Enable compressor 1, this is 2 and 3. And 4. Save, distribute, reload frame, compressor not visible, and disable, enable. Can disable this single, this is an alarm, temperature too high. Works. Okay, quick summary. So the goal was create a new widget, a new object display. So we started finding a good image for the compressor. We duplicate it and paste in the project library. Open, we create a new parameter called isVisible. And then use that attribute in the simple dynamic to show and to make the widget visible or not visible. Important to save before to use it, so we placed 4 times and linked to the 4 compressor variable compu1234. We have also placed here below a switch object display for the enable of the compressor. Okay, that's all. No, it's not all. We can see again how to make a backup. I repeat that we have to make a backup of just one file. It is in the project folder. So we can, the file is the notes.db. So copy, paste, and rename. Okay, now the exercise is finished.